In Iran, we need a government permission first.
و در یک سال گذشته بسیاری از کتاب‌هایی که قبلا اجازه چاپ گرفته بودند برای تجدید چاپ بهشون اجازه داده نشده.
In the past year, many books that were originally given permission and approved for publication, the permissions were actually taken back.
و دردناک‌تر اونجاست که گاهی از اوقات به کتابی اجازه چاپ میدن اما دادگاه اون رو قبول نداره.
And worst of all, the most painful is when a book is allowed to be published, but the permission is not accepted by a court.
در چند مورد کتابی اجازه چاپ داشته ولیکن ناشر، نویسنده و مترجم رو تحت تعقیب قرار دادن.
In a few cases, a book was granted permission for publication, but the publisher, the author, and the translator were criminally persecuted.
همچنین بسیاری از سایت‌های اینترنتی رو فیلتر کردن.
The same holds true for many internet sites that have been filtered by the government.
دولت مجدداً در جمع‌آوری ماهواره‌ها سختگیری می‌کنه.
The government is again being more agitated over the satellites and is removing them at a faster pace.
و این امر خلاف قانونه، زیرا قانون جمع‌آوری ماهواره‌ها یه مدت معینی داشته که تموم شده.
The act is illegal because the decision to remove these satellites was only for a short period of time legally speaking and that time has already expired.
وضعیت کارگران در ایران اسفناکه.
The situation of workers in Iran is very sorrowful.
امسال تعداد زیادی از کارگران شغل خودشون از دست دادن، اخراج شدن.
A large number of workers lost their jobs this year.
دستمزد کارگران کفاف مخارج سنگین زندگی رو نمیده.
What they earn is not sufficient for covering the heavy costs of daily life.
در اعتراض به این وضعیت اعتصابات کارگری در ایران بسیار زیاده.
In response, there are numerous labor strikes across the country.
و متاسفانه کسی هم به خواست اونها ترتیب اثر نمیده.
But regretfully, nobody has followed up with their demands.
آقای منصور اوسانلو راننده شرکت واحد حدود 7 ماه در زندان بود که اخیراً با وثیقه سنگینی هم آزاد شد.
منصور اوسانلو, a driver of the bus system or union, was imprisoned for about 7 months, and he was recently released with heavy bail.
آقای منصور اوسانلو و تعدادی دیگر اعتراض داشتند به کمی دستمزدشون.
Mansoor Osanlu and a number of his colleagues were objecting to their low salaries. And they wanted to have their own guild. He was released after 7 months with heavy bail.
و تعداد زیادی راننده که اعتصاب کرده بودن اخراج شدند.
And a large group of the bus drivers who went on strike were actually lost their jobs.
و به عبارتی اعتصابات کارگری پاداشی جز اخراج از کار و احیانا زندان نداره.
What this shows is that labor strikes will be rewarded either through the loss of a job or through imprisonment.
طبق گفته وزیر رفاه و امور اجتماعی در ایران حدود 12% مردم ایران زیر خط فقر زندگی می کنند.
According to figures released by the Ministry of Welfare and Social Justice, about 12% of the people in Iran live under the poverty line.
اگر این آمار صحت داشته باشه یعنی بیشتر از این نباشه برای کشور ثروتمندی مانند ایران فاجعه است.
If these figures are in fact accurate and if we should not be expecting even higher ones, this is in fact a disaster for a wealthy nation such as Iran.
ایران با داشتن معادنی از قبیل نفت، گاز، اورانیوم، مس کشور ثروتمندیه.
Iran has rich natural resources, oil and gas, uranium, copper.
برنامه‌ریزی غلط اقتصادی و فساد اداری چنین نتایجی رو به بار آورده.
Lack of economic planning and financial corruption at the administrative level has resulted in the predicaments we face today.
طبق گزارش کارشناسان اقتصادی، ایران از لحاظ ریسک سرمایه‌گذاری در میان 100 کشور رتبه 96 رو گرفته.
According to economic analysts, Iran is the 96th country on the list of 100 countries in terms of highest risk for investments.
Iran سال گذشته در رتبه 77 بود و امسال با تشدید بحران‌های سیاسی داخلی و بین‌المللی به رتبه 96 تنزل پیدا کرده.
Last year, Iran was 77th on the list, but this year it's 96th as a result of increased political crisis, both within the country and at the regional and international level. Drug abuse, illicit drug abuse, is also increasing in Iran.
طبق گزارشی که چند ماه قبل سازمان ملل متحد منتشر کرد، ایران بالاترین درصد اعتیاد رو داشت.
According to a report released by the United Nations several months ago, Iran has the highest number of drug addicts.
در چنین وضعیتی، طبق گزارش ستاد مبارزه با مواد مخدر، بودجه مبارزه با مواد مخدر رو هم کاهش دادن.
Under such circumstances, according to a report by the Unit for Fighting Illicit Drugs, the budget designated for fighting illicit drug use has actually been reduced in the past year.
به گفته محققین این ستاد فقط روزی یک ریال برای پیشگیری از اعتیاد در کشور بودجه گذاشته.
According to researchers at this center, about just one rial, the equivalent of, let's say, a cent here, is designated to fight illicit drug abuse in the country per day.
فساد مالی در ایران باعث ازدیاد چشمگیر فاصله طبقاتی شده.
Financial corruption in Iran has led to a clear manifestation of a class gap.
آقای احمدی نژاد هنگام انتخابات وعده مبارزه با فساد مالی را دادند، اما با گذشت بیش از یک سال از ریاست جمهوری ما هیچ مبارزه‌ای ندیدیم و وضعیت مالی مردم هم به گونه ای است که گفتم.
During his election campaign, Mr. Ahmadinejad promised to fight financial corruption. A year has passed and we have still to see any changes.
تعداد کثیر زندانیان سیاسی یکی از نقاط قابل توجه در کارنامه نقض حقوق بشر در ایران.
The increased number of political prisoners in Iran is yet another testament to the political report card of Iran, especially in the area of human rights.
وضعیت زندانیان سیاسی از زندانیان عادی نامناسب‌تر هم هست.
Political prisoners actually live under harsher circumstances in prisons than ordinary prisoners.
زیرا زندانیان عادی امکان دسترسی به وکیل رو در حین بازجویی دارن.
At least ordinary prisoners have the right to access a lawyer when during inspections and interrogations.
اما زندانیان سیاسی غالبا تا خاتمه تحقیقات و ارسال پرونده به دادگاه حق ملاقات با وکیل خودشون رو ندارن و این امر میتونه ماها به طول بیانجامه.
But usually for political prisoners, they don't have the right to see their lawyer until a full interrogation of a case has been conducted and a case has been represented before the court, which can obviously take months.
بازجویی و تحقیقاتی که در اتاق‌های دربسته و با فشارهای روحی و روانی و بدون حضور وکیل